Depending on how you look at it, a work of art can have plenty of curb appeal. Hari Srinivasan shows us the work of a master.
Millions of art lovers have traveled the world to see marvelous Monets and remarkable Rembrandts. But all those art lovers would fit into a tiny corner of this museum, the virtual museum of the internet, where untold numbers are at this very moment seeing and marveling and sharing the three-dimensional pavement drawings of English artist Julian Beever.
So really the internet becomes your pavement in
exactly.
A way.
That's my medium, really. If it wasn't for the internet, my stuff would be totally unknown.
This is Julian being rescued by Batman and Robin from the ledge of an imaginary burning building. The sailboat in this picture isn't real. Neither is the pool it floats on. The reel of hose is not real. Neither is the water, nor is the drain. And Felix the cat isn't really climbing out of a manhole wearing a costume for Chinese New Year. We caught up with Julian Beever a few days ago in New Orleans as he began his latest creation.
In the past, I used to get quite insecure, really, on the first day, not knowing that I would have enough time to get it finished. But now I try to be a bit more cool about it. I know I've done so many of these, and they always do get finished.
He was commissioned by a business group to come up with a theme that reflects New Orleans city life. First, he draws his design in miniature.
It's a very expansive drawing, this one. It's figures and things coming out of a hole, exploding into life, blowing a fanfare outwards to the world.
Before chalk touches concrete comes a rope trick that helps his sketch grow in scale. The entire process will take 3.5 days. Beever says the first day is the hardest.
Looks like it's just a bit of scribble, but actually the information there is probably the toughest bit to get done.
And there's the physical toll from drawing on the ground and running back and forth to look through the camera hundreds of times just to gain perspective.
Feeling pretty tired now. Well, none of us getting any younger, are we?
No, we're not.
To get the full picture, you have to see Beaver's work through a lens.
I think because the camera limits what your brain can do, it limits the brain's ability to judge distance. It makes you only use one eye, and therefore you can make the brain believe stuff that otherwise it wouldn't believe.
So it's really, your art wouldn't be your art without the camera.
No, you need to have a lens or a camera or something to view it with.
The original plan was to draw on a busy downtown sidewalk. The threat of rain moved him to this covered valet entrance at Harrah's Casino. How much of a following does Julian Beever have? Just ask a parking valet.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of his paintings on the internet. It's amazing, you know, it's how it comes to life.
After art school, Beever became a busker. He supported himself by making two-dimensional drawings on pavement for pennies from passersby. He turned to three-dimensional art not by error, but by trial, starting with a woman in a swimming pool. Her leg didn't come out quite right.
I didn't really have the experience at that time to realize exactly how to do that leg in relation to the height of the camera.
But he learned from that mistake and has been wowing people ever since.
It looks dimensional to
me. It does look dimensional.
Yes. Isn't that amazing? That is just amazing. This made the trip all worthwhile.
Oh, yes. So
and she hasn't seen anything yet. Beaver's bare bones chalk outlines are fleshing out.
So we're seeing who? What is this, Louis Armstrong bursting through the sidewalk here?
Well, it's Louis Armstrong if I can get a likeness. If I can't, then it's just any musician.
And when it all works, it looks like this. His New Orleans drawing, fully realized. An amazing piece of art. But like all of Julian Beaver's pavement drawings, it is destined to be swept away, erased by time.
It doesn't worry me at all, the fact that the drawing will disappear after a couple of days in the rain, because the final product is the photograph. And if that photograph goes on the internet, then thousands of people will see it and it'll be there forever. So it doesn't vanish, really. The drawing on the ground is just a vehicle.
Just one more way Julian Beever keeps things in perspective.
La-da-da-da-da. 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 Every day I pick myself up and say, hey there world, we're making the sun shine. You and me, together with he and she, hanging in and making the sun shine. Clouds may come, storms may blow, but after the rain, look up for the rain.
Sometimes we all need to just forget about the money and spread a little love. Let's go.
Seems like everybody's got a price. I wonder how they sleep at night. When the sale comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. Got shades on your eyes and your heels so high that you can't even have a good time. Everybody looks to their left. Everybody looks to their right. Can you feel that? Yeah, we'll pay them with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just want to make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the yeah, ba-bling, ba-bling. Want to make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Hey, yeah.